Episode Guide, Circus Time.
Hello, my name is Sarina Candelo, and I play Belle on MOSI and Moo. It is my hope that this episode guide will give you the support you may need to explore, integrate, and expand our program into your classroom or home. In it, we're going to discuss the components of our Circus Time dance story, including our dance adventure, nursery rhyme, and related dance games. In our Circus Time dance story, MOSI and Moo jump under the big top to pop like popcorn, swing on the trapeze, and fill in for the missing clown act. In this episode, we cover locomotor and non-locomotor movements, the creation of a variety of body shapes, and using dance to express the movements of the acts that one would find in the circus. Specifically, we are exploring the hilarity of the clown act, the grace of the trapeze artist, and the dynamic movement of sizzling and popping popcorn. We also find the challenge of balancing on one foot and turning our bodies upside down with our wobbly clown dance. Our opening song for the episode always acts as the solution to our dance adventure. This overarching curriculum theme of circus pivots on introducing the circus acts that unfold under the big top. In our Let's Clown Around dance game, we explore more of the movement potential of what one might find at the circus. Pretending, improvising, and mimicking these kinds of movements is absolutely delightful for this age group and provides diverse dynamics, body shapes, and fantastic locomotor patterns too. In every MOSI and Moo dance adventure, we touch upon different core values. In our circus episode, MOSI finds the courage to perform in front of an audience. The notion of finding the courage to do something new is the character trait that we really focus upon. I try to explain to the children that being brave means we do not let fear hold us back from exploring something new that might develop a new skill or do something that is truly right. I also try to make it clear that when you use courage, many times you do not feel like you're courageous inside. I do my best to affirm my dancers' bravery or courage while dancing. Little reminders to show them that they are brave will encourage them to see themselves that way. Many times in my dance class, you could hear me say, "You can do it, dancers. That took courage to perform. Good for you." Here are some questions you can ask your children about being courageous or brave. What are some ways you are courageous? Have you ever been afraid to do something? What are new things that you have just learned? Did they take courage? When it comes to developing the dance language for the child in this episode, we can unpack this language from taking a closer look at the steps we use. The actions in this episode, or what can we do, includes the following. In the wobbly dance, we do a step called the tick-tock, where the child shifts their weight from side to side like this. I have a little song that teaches them this movement. It goes like this. Tick, tock, tick, tock. I'm a little cuckoo clock. Tick, tock, tick, tock. Now I'm striking 3 o'clock. Cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. Can also do 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. In the song Popcorn Pop, the simple movement of jumping up and down is how we roll. I love the middle section where we sizzle in the pan only to pop it out again. This song is quite rhythmic in nature. It shows up again in Let's Clown Around dance games, but this time we take the popping in different zones and tempos. We jump side to side with our popcorn up and down, forward and back. We go really fast and slow too. In the tricks on the trapeze, we dance in a 3-4 time and shift our weight side to side. The action of swinging. This shows up in modern dance too, specifically in the Limone technique. Here we encourage the child to extend their arms and bend their knees while swinging. I always say that the ability of shifting one's weight side to side is the heart of being able to dance well. It is a very, very important skill to have. In our nursery rhyme dance, if you're happy and you know it, we take the movements of clapping, stomping, and shouting hooray to create a little dance by stringing all those movements together. Staying on the beat and repeating the actions is truly the delight in this song. In our dance games, Let's Clown Around, we explore a wider array of actions that one would see at the circus. These games are crowd pleasers, and they're very easy to understand. They're challenging in nature, and trust me, they're so much fun. Here you find movements like juggling, driving a funny car, and floating and bouncing like a balloon. Now, ways to expand the theme of circus are many. And as everybody knows, I absolutely love integrating the arts with pairing up a craft idea with the dances too. Painting a circus clown by using a handprint on a piece of paper, so sweet, or exploring different clown faces just even with coloring. You can make one that is funny, surprised, or sleepy. Another fun game to extend this episode is to put some painter's tape straight on the floor and have the children do a performance on the tightrope. I also love balancing act games, like seeing how many paper plates they can stack on their head and cross the room, or can you travel with a beanbag on your head across the room? In all of our episodes and these games, children are using and developing their balance, bilateral coordination, physical endurance, motor control. They're establishing posture and all their gross motor skills. There are also incredible children's books on this theme, the circus too, that you can read to your children. My top faves are Harold's Circus Book by Crockett Johnson and Olivia Saves the Circus by Ian Falconer. I hope that this episode guide was helpful. Please check out our website for a more comprehensive list of ways to expand our Circus Time dance story. Thank you so much for listening.
MOSI!